Good evening. My name is Joe Chapman. I am the senior professor here at the University of North Georgia, and it is my pleasure to welcome you to A Night on Broadway. During the first 40 years of my time here at North Georgia, I had the opportunity to direct various choirs, bands, and orchestra, but it's now in my 41st year that I finally have the opportunity to direct musical theater. It has been a treat, especially because of these wonderful students that you will hear and see in just a moment. They have made the job a pleasure and fun to do. I must tell you, though, specifically, I am not the true director of this ensemble. I am merely the acting director. Our director is my esteemed colleague and best friend, Dr. Lee Barrow. Dr. Barrow is not with us this evening in the auditorium because he is in the process of recovering from brain surgery earlier in March. The good news is that the doctor says that he will be ready to go at the beginning of fall semester. But thanks to COVID, we now have live stream, and you can rest assured that he is with us tonight in his hospital bed as he is watching. So this one's for you, Lee. Before we begin the program, I would ask you to make sure that your cell phone is silenced. We ask you to refrain from any flash photography. And also, we have an intermission. It will be about 8 minutes. If you need to exit the auditorium at some time other than that, please don't try to do it through the middle aisle. All you will find there is a seat in the back row. There is no exit from there. And further, I would request that you don't leave via this door unless you, of course, plan to be the featured performer in the next thing, because you'll be swept on the stage. So just sit back and enjoy A Night on Broadway. Thanks for joining us.
Time called a golden age. must. I fail the calculus. Does God work out? He must. Those sweaty abject. Could that image be more hot? Let me just enjoy the thought. School was rough, but now it's not. Cause now there's hope. It's all so sad. Stupid with love. But I can't get it. Watch this girl self-educate. I've learned math so I can learn love.
Listening to the men who aren't quite men yet. for I know the feeling. How am I supposed to operate if I'm just tossed around by feet? Like on an unexpected date with a stranger who might talk too fast or ask me questions about myself before I decided that he can ask me questions about myself. He might sit too close or call the waiter by his first name or eat where he goes. But eat the cookie before the cream. But what scares me the most, what scares me the most, is what if when he sees me, what if he doesn't like it? What if he runs the other way and I can't hide from that? What happens then if when he knows me, he's only disappointed? What if I give myself away only to have it given back? I could live with it.
How do you live with that?
So I'm just fine inside my ship-shaped mind. This way I get the best of views. So that when he sees me, I want him to. Being cautious, I can't risk reckless dating due to my miscalculating why. A certain suitor stands in line, I've seen it in movies, most made for television. You cannot be too careful when it comes to sharing your life. I could end up a miserable life. Sorry girls, he could be criminal, some sort of psychopath who escaped from an institution somewhere where they don't have girls. He could have masterminded some way to find me. They could be colorblind. How untrustworthy is that? He could be less than kind, or even worse, he could be very nice, have lovely eyes, and make me laugh, come out of hiding. What do I do with that? Oh God, what if when he sees me, how my committee knows it? What if he opens a door and I can't close it? What happens then if when he holds me, my heart is in motion, I'm not prepared for that, I'm scared of breaking open, but still I can't help from open.
Someone who, when he sees me, wants to again.
Someone's being bashful. That's no way to be, not with me. Can't you see that I am just as embarrassed as you? And I can understand your print of you. I've always been shy. I confess that I'm shy. Can't
glass. Now shoulders up and stand up tall and do not work or try to float.
I feel a little foolish.
Am I floating?
Like a sinking boat.
Give a bow.
What happens now?
Your hand receives a kiss.
Most of all, remember.
Freedom.
Shall I join my brother's
side? When our ranks begin.
sure we can make a sound. When you're falling in a forest and there's nobody around, do you ever really crash or even make a sound? Did I even make a sound? Did I even make a sound? Did I ever make a sound? Did I ever make a sound? On the outside, I was taking it. Did I ever make more than what I've always been? Because I tap, tap, tapping on it.
Except, of course, the thoughtful ones who think like you and me. Obnoxious folk who talk too loud, I wish they would desist. I'll put them on my list, they never will be missed.
He's got them on the list, he's got them on the list, and they'll none of them be missed, they'll none of them be missed.
There's the models who weigh 90 pounds and tell you they are fat. I'll put them on the list, I'll put them on the list. Their friends who, when you need their help, dismiss you just like that. I'll put them on the list, they never would be missed. Those shallow, ditzy students with the latest retro look, who pass a class with untold ease but never crack a book. Those friends who, when they're out of school, are fond of telling tales. The teacher who, for hours, makes you practice all your scales without a single thought about your ever aching wrist. A humble pianist, he's higher on the list.
We've got him on the list, we've got him on the list, and I don't think he'll be missed. I'm sure he'll not be missed.
There's the Facebook friend who shares a daily picture of her cat. I'll put her on the list, she never would be missed. And wannabes on YouTube who don't know they're singing flat. They never would be missed. They never would be missed. Those egocentric folks whose actions really make me sick. They're always taking pictures with this stupid selfie stick. The patron sitting next to you who won't put down her phone, who leaves it on so you will hear her ludicrous ringtone. And then when it starts ringing, she just lets the sound persist. She's the first one on my list. I'm sure she won't be missed.
You may put him on the list. You may put him on the list. And a lot of them be missed. They'll none of them be missed.
awesome job, Kevin. Now it's our time to go out and set the world's people free. We can do it together, you and me, just mostly me.
Great, we can agree. The Heavenly Father has chosen you and me.
us this evening. Before we present our final number, I'd like to recognize a few people. Most importantly, our choreographer, Professor Kylie Groom Stacy. Okay. You see, she has the next generation of the music theater ensemble. That's so beautiful. Several other people. It's nice to be seen. It's nice to be heard. So thank you to Dylan Hoffman and Hannah Chapman for lights and sound. Wonderful costumes. My wife, Janie, thank you. And we would also like to thank the parents, the significant others, for all these people up here. And we appreciate all that you have done to support them and get them through this week. It's a lot of time and a lot of energy and a lot of effort. Also, I would want you to know that tomorrow night we are performing. This will be the exact same program tomorrow night, but an entirely different performance. The beauty of live performance. So I invite your friends and neighbors. You're welcome to come back yourself to see the exact same program, but an entire, who knows what will happen tomorrow. Something new and unexpected will be wonderful there. Once again, thank you for joining us. Please enjoy now the Lullaby of Broadway.
Angelos and Maxis, when the